Today, I want to answer the question, how does softproofing work in Capture One? The reason the question's come up is that I recently posted an article explaining why I'd switched from using Lightroom to Capture One for processing my Fuji images. Now, if you're interested in that, I'll put the link in the information below. But let's get back to the subject at hand. Here you can see an image that I've already processed using Capture One. Now, when it comes to actually printing this image, ordinarily I'd softproof it to see what it looks like first and then make any further adjustments I need based on the softproof. Now, in Capture One, it's not quite as obvious how softproofing works, and that's because the image is always being softproofed. The problem is, it doesn't know which paper and printer that you're going to actually use. For that, you need to actually set up a printer profile in there. The first thing we need to do is go and look at the Process tab. And that's up here, it looks like a little cogged icon. When you get in there, you can see we've got a number of process recipes already set up. The process recipes tell Capture One how to actually convert the raw file into an image and what type of image you're going to use. Now, at the moment, I've got a process recipe that I've created called TIFF 16-bit with an Adobe RGB profile. What I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate that. Create a new recipe, and we'll call that TIFF 16-bit. But rather than Adobe RGB, I'm going to call it PhotoSpeed Natural Soft Texture, or NST for short. The reason for this is that I print a lot using PhotoSpeed NST paper. Now, if I come down to the basic panel here, you can see that it's set up already for TIFF and an 8-bit, so I'll just change that to 16-bit. Options are uncompressed rather than compressed, and I'm happy with that, but we get down to ICC Profile. Now, at the moment, it's set to Adobe RGB, and what we really want is to use one of the printer profiles. If I do the drop down though, you can't see any other profiles other than sRGB, so I need to take this Show All option. Once I've clicked that, I can actually see all the profiles that are loaded on my computer, including this one here, which is the natural soft textured paper for my Epson 3880 printer. As soon as I take that, what you see is that the preview now updates to reflect how that image looks if it was printed on that paper. So I've now created a profile that I can use to view the soft proof of my image. If I don't want to view it as a soft proof, I can just go back to it looking like the Adobe RGB color space. When I want to see what it looks like in the paper profile that I'll be using, I just need to click on my PhotoSpeed NST version. Now, as you can see, a lot of the blacks in the image are actually now looking very grey, and that's because there isn't the contrast level in a print that you get on a screen, and so you may want to adjust for that. If you do, this is what you would do. So here's my master file that I've created over here, and that's had all the adjustments applied. I can now right click on that and create a new variant, and I'm going to use this clone variant. Now, what that does is it creates a second copy of the image, and you can see here we've got this little 1 and 2 just to show that they're part of the same image. So if I go back to the original, I can now put that back to Adobe RGB and see that, but notice it also changes the process recipe for the other. You only have one process recipe that you can view for. So I'm going to click on the NST paper again. Now, because I'm working on a clone of my original image, it doesn't matter if I make further adjustments. I'm going to select to open it with Photoshop when it's been processed. So I'll process it now. And that's now converting the image so that it will be rendered and opened in Photoshop. Now, I get this warning here, embedded profile mismatch. The reason for that is my Photoshop version is set up to warn me if I open an image that doesn't have the same profile as my default working space. Now, my default working space in Photoshop is set to Profoto RGB. You could equally have it set to something like Adobe RGB. But the embedded profile that we've got in the image is this natural soft texture one. If I open that, so I'm going to use the embedded profile, and I'll open that in Photoshop, and what you see is the image, and it's ready to print. notice that you've lost all the grayness that you had in the shadows. And the reason for that is that this isn't being soft-proofed. It's actually the image in a normal view. And that's why I said that Capture One is always set up to soft-proof based on the ICC profile setup in your recipe. If you switch to one that's simple Adobe RGB, that's the display you see. I hope that's explained how Capture One does soft proofing and how you can actually view a soft proof before sending it to print. Now you can also print from Capture One. If you go to the File menu, you'll find the Print option at the bottom. And here you can see the various options for the printer, including the color profile that you want to use. Watch what happens if I now change this to use my natural soft texture. You see a soft proof in the print dialog box, so it's showing you what it will look like, and you can change your rendering intent. Now at the moment, my rendering intent is set to be perceptual on the screen. We can change it to be relative colorimetric, which gives a slightly darker view, or you can use the absolute colorimetric. So these are all different ways of rendering out of gamma colors. You also have an option for sharpening. And when you've made all your settings, all you need to do is press print to send it to the printer. I hope you found this useful. I'm Robin Whalley. You've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you next time for another video.